going, dear.
Sorry. Don't sit there crooning like a bilious pigeon.
No!
Oh! Heavens, what a sound. Ow!
Oh, God.
How do you do it, if I may ask?
Oh, simple phonetics, the science of speech. That's my profession, also my hobby.
You see the difficulty?
What difficulty?
To get her to talk grammar. The mere pronunciation is easy enough.
I don't want to talk grammar, I want to talk like a lady.
I'll bet you all the expenses of the experiment that you can't do it. And I'll pay for the lessons.
Oh, you're real good. Thank you, Captain.
Eliza, you are to stay here for the next 6 months, learning how to speak beautifully, like a lady in a forest shop.
I shall make a duchess out of this braggle-tailed guttersnipe.
Oh.
The streets will be strewn with the bodies of men, shooting themselves for your sake before I'm done with you.
You swear a great deal too much. I don't mind your damning and blasting and what the devil and where the devil and who the
Mrs.
devil.
Mrs. Pierce, this language from your lips, really.
And how did you know that she is here?
Well, I'll tell you, Governor. If you let me get a word in, I'm willing to tell you. I'm wanting to tell you. I'm waiting to tell you.
Tell me about the girl.
Well, she's coming to see you.
I don't remember asking her.
You didn't. I asked her. If you'd known her, you wouldn't have asked her.
Indeed. Why?
Well, it's like this. She's a common flower girl. I picked her off the curbstone.
And invited her to my at-home!
Well, that'll be all right.
Mrs. and Miss Eynsford Hinton.
Oh, Lord.
How do you do?
How do you do?
You are the life and soul of the Royal Society's soirees. But really, you're rather trying on more commonplace occasions.
Yeah, what are you sniggering at?
New small talk! You do it so awfully well!
If I was doing it proper, what was you laughing at? Have I said anything I oughtn't?
Are you walking across the park, Mr. Doolittle? If so, I...
Walk? Not bloody lightly. I'm going in a taxi.
You two infinitely stupid male creatures.
Man!